For people who are perhaps unfamiliar with the tragic history behind this film, can you tell us a little bit about that and why you felt it was so vitally important to dramatize it in this way?
Well, there's been priest molestation going on in the Catholic Church for nobody knows how long. And it kind of came to a head in Boston. There was 90 priests in a very short period of time who had molested children. And it started to dawn on people, how can such a giant number of priests be doing this and no one really know about it in the upper echelon of the church? And that led to the Archdiocese, and which eventually led to the entire nation and then to the world. And so what we came to see was there's just a giant cover-up. And we use this movie in a dispassionate way. It's not salacious. We don't see priests doing these things to kids in some dark corner somewhere. It's not sentimentalized. We take the audience through the story in a dispassionate, journalistic way that by the end of it leaves you no doubt of its credibility and morality.
And obviously you're working with a fantastic director and cast. Can you talk about your experiences working with the rest of the team behind this film?
Yeah, these are the best of the best. They're my peers. A lot of them are theater actors. A lot of them are my friends. Tom is an actor as well, so he understands, you know, what it is to be an actor and how to work as an actor. And with this script and that cast and those people leading us through it, it was one of the great joyful experiences. Even though it was such a heavy subject matter, the level at which we were making film was really very elevated.
How important do you feel it is for a film that does address this subject matter to receive the critical and awards recognition, validation that it seems to be doing at the moment?
Well, ultimately, what you don't really think about are the victims and how they have not had a voice and have not been represented. And so this means a great deal to them. The story, when it first came out, meant a great deal to them, but a movie has a way of reaching the culture in a way that a print film can only partially do. And so it's of utmost importance, and it has it started to already produce results. Just last week in Seattle, the Seattle Archdiocese released the names of 77 priests, pedophile predators, who had been molesting children since 1926. Now, they've never done that. There's only 13 archdioceses in the world that's actually published a list of the names of priests who molested children. And that happened, I think, because of this movie. And I think that there's a movement coalescing around that for more transparency around that issue.
How important was it for you and the film to be historically accurate with the information?
It was incredibly important because there's so much riding on the veracity of the piece. And at the end of the day, if you couldn't, you know, dot all your I's and cross your T's, you were vulnerable. And I think we all knew that, and the movie would be vulnerable. So, really kudos to Tom and Josh Singer, that from the very beginning of working on the script, they were devoted to getting it right, to the point where they were sitting with the spotlight team over and over and over again, even when the final script, they sat for 11 hours and went through the script word for word, making sure that everything was as close to being true as possible. There's a different demographic that will go see The Hulk. The good thing is I've been doing these kinds of movies for a long time, so there's also, I have a relationship with the audiences that like these kinds of movies. Ultimately, it's great filmmaking, you know. It's no different than Zodiac or, you know, the Revenant in a way. It's just, it's very good filmmaking, and people tend to want to go see good movies, you know.
Well, the history behind the story it goes back 1,000 years. This has been going on in the Catholic Church for way, way, way too long. We know that there have been cases that have, throughout the centuries of this happening. But what the journalists did, they really brought this to light in a very clear and broad sense. And specific, when I say broad, I mean the information was huge, and it went to a broad audience. I wanted to be a part of it for that reason. It's a story that should be told again and again and again. And I always wanted to work with Tom, and I love Mark Ruffalo, and the script was gorgeous. Oh, Mark's a wonderful actor. I always loved him. We knew each other sort of peripherally, but then on this film, well, I only worked with him, and I was very lucky. I think, I have to say, I wasn't shocked by what had happened. I was shocked at how many people were complicit in covering it up.
Well, none of us ever thought this would be a movie. I mean, I'll tell you, what we thought was, you want to make a movie about people reading documents, talking on the phone, getting doors slammed in their faces? Good luck to you. So we never in our wildest dreams thought this would be a movie. Two producers approached us, Bly Faust and Nicole Rockland, and they presented the idea to us as a movie about the importance of journalism at a time when journalism was being challenged financially very seriously. And they seemed very sincere, very hardworking. They had some good credits, and we just decided to gamble, roll the dice, and let them give it a try. And we're all very, very happy that we did. Working with Mark was a wonderful experience. Mark is an incredibly talented, gifted, generous, caring, committed individual. And we spent a lot of time together. Mark came to my home. He hung out in my neighborhood with me. He shadowed me at the Boston Globe. He sat next to me as I did interviews. We really got to know each other pretty well. We discovered that we had a lot of things in common. And it was just a sensational experience to get to know someone who is as talented and committed as he is. Well, the reason it matters so much to me, I think, and to tens of thousands of others, is because it really keeps the issue of clergy sexual abuse in the public eye. And it also, perhaps more importantly, really validates the experience of the survivors of sex abuse who, before we came along, were really a voiceless constituency. And what's wonderful about the movie is it gives our work a second life with a much, much broader audience. And I think all the good our stories did is magnified by this movie. And that, I think, is really what's most gratifying to all of us on the Spotlight team. Well, it's very nice to be recognized and validated and have a movie out there that shows people why investigative reporting is so important. After all, I've dedicated my life to this work. And, you know, it's not often we feel appreciated in this way. And I think it's a great thing for the Boston Globe, and which has maintained its commitment to investigative reporting. I think it's a great thing for journalism as a whole. I think it's a great thing for the survivors of clergy sex abuse. I think it's a great thing for the Catholic Church if they will take the message seriously and do everything that's possible to rectify the problem.